Hello everyone, welcome back to my channel Trouble Free. In today's video, we are going to learn about block cipher principles and algorithms in the subject of information security. So far, I made videos on operating systems, web technologies, managerial economics and financial analysis. And now it is information security. If you have not yet subscribed to my channel, do subscribe and hit the bell icon so that you can receive a notification whenever I post a video. So that it will be helpful for you for your exams and also to learn concepts of that particular subjects. And in today's video, we are going to learn about block cipher, its basic introduction, and what are the principles of block cipher and what are the algorithms of block cipher. I'll just give you the list of the algorithms in this video. I'll not explain about all the algorithms in detail. We will be learning about each and every algorithm in detail in next individual videos. Okay, first, what do you mean by block cipher? In block cipher, what we do is we have plain text, right? Our main motive is to convert our plain text into ciphertext so that the attacker or the third person cannot understand what we are sending. So here what we do is we will be dividing the plain text into number of blocks. Okay, suppose you have some A, B, C, D, E, F as your plain text. You'll be dividing it into number of blocks. That means A, B, C as one block and D, E, F as one block. So you'll be dividing the plain text into number of blocks. Okay. So after dividing the plain text into number of blocks, we will be converting each individual block into a ciphertext. Okay. For each individual block, we will be generating an individual ciphertext block. Right. Got it? Now, block size, that means we are dividing each plain text into number of blocks, right? So each block can have a size of 40 or 56 or 64 or 128 or 256 bits. Okay, each block can have that particular sizes, right? And next, whenever we are dividing the blocks and we are converting the plain text into ciphertext, we must make sure that always the plain text block size will be equal to the ciphertext block size. Suppose the block size of our plain text is 40 bits, then our corresponding ciphertext has also should be of 40 bits, right? So the corresponding ciphertext should be of same size, right? Next, for every plain text, as I already said, so this is one plain text block, and for this the corresponding ciphertext block is this. Okay, and this is the second, and this is the second, and this is the third, and this is the third. So the conversion of plain text to ciphertext will happen through key. This is, you already know that. So by using the key, by using a secret key, by using a secret code, which is nothing but key, we will be converting plain text into ciphertext. For each and every single block of plain text, one individual ciphertext block will be generated. Okay, so first, whatever the plain text you have, you will be dividing it into number of blocks. Okay, after dividing your plain text into number of blocks, you will be using the key, and with that key you will convert it into ciphertext. Okay, so now after generating the corresponding ciphertext, now what you have to do is you have to combine all the ciphertext blocks. Suppose you have something like this A, B, C, D, F as your plain text, and you divided it as AB as one block, CD as one block, and EF as one block. Okay, and for this each and every plain text, by using some key, you will be generating its corresponding ciphertext. Let us consider the ciphertext as something like X, Y, K, L, M, O, like that. So these are the corresponding ciphertext blocks for each and every plain text block. Now what we have to do is we have to combine all these things. That means we will get X, Y, K, L, M, O. So this is the corresponding ciphertext of this corresponding plain text. Okay, and you have several algorithms, right, to generate a ciphertext. I already explained about those algorithms in the previous video. If you have missed out those videos, I'll give you the link in the description. You can check out and you can have a look at those videos as well, right? So this is the concept of block cipher. Simply, you have to, what you have to remember is all the plain text will be converted into individual blocks, and those blocks will be converted into ciphertext. The block size of both plain text and ciphertext will be same. So now, after generating ciphertext, what will happen? This ciphertext will be sent to the receiver side, right? So on reaching the receiver side, what happens? Again, the receiver will use his key and he will again generate the corresponding plain text, okay? Again, the plain text also will be in the form of blocks. He will combine all the blocks and he will retrieve the actual message, okay? This is what happens in the case of a block cipher. Now we will try to understand what are the principles of block cipher. Actually, we have three design principles. That means we have to keep these three things in our mind when we are designing a block cipher. Okay, and what are those design principles of block cipher? Let us see. The first one is number of rounds. Each and every algorithm will have some rounds. Like 10 rounds or 16 rounds or 20 rounds, depending on the designing of the algorithm, each and every algorithm will have several rounds. So how many ever higher number of rounds we will have, that much tough the algorithm, that much tough the algorithm will be to the third party person or to the hacker to break it. Okay, suppose an algorithm is having 10 rounds and the other algorithm is having 20 rounds. Out of these two algorithms, the algorithm which is having 20 rounds is harder, okay, than compared to the algorithm which is having 10 rounds. So the one thing which you have to keep in your mind is number of rounds should be more. How many more rounds you'll have, that much hard the algorithm will become for the hacker, right? And the second one is design of function f. You will be designing a function, right? Based on that function only, like you'll have a function. You know what a function is? F of x is equal to ax plus b. These kind of things are called functions, right? Not ax plus b. It should not be so simple. You must design a function f which will be very much complicated to understand. How much ever harder the function is, that much time it will take for the, that much more time the hacker will take to decode or to break that algorithm, okay? Number of rounds should be higher and the function you are designing should be complicated. You can take non-linear functions. Instead of taking linear functions, you can take non-linear functions, okay? Linear functions are very easy, right? Next is key scheduling algorithm. And key scheduling algorithm, you should be very careful while you are generating the key, because key is very important. Even though if there is a minor change in key, suppose actually the key is A, B, C, D, let us suppose. By mistake, instead of generating A, B, C, D, you have generated it just as A, B, C. Only one letter is the difference, but when you use this to convert plain text to ciphertext, there will be a lot of change in ciphertext. So many values, many positions will be changed in ciphertext just because of small mistake you do in key. So that is why you must be very careful when you are scheduling keys. When you are generating keys, you must be very careful. Okay, so this is about design principles. Number of rounds should be more. How many more rounds are there, that much hard the algorithm will be. Design of function f also should be very complicated. You must design a very complicated function instead of designing a simple function. It is better you will design a non-linear function instead of designing linear functions. And the next one is key scheduling algorithm. Key also should be scheduled very carefully, because even a small change in key value will give you a big changes in the ciphertext positions. Okay, so these three are the design principles of block cipher. So next we will be learning about what are the modes of operation of block cipher and what are the block cipher algorithms we have. I'll just give you the list of modes of operations of block cipher and the algorithms of block cipher. In detail I'll be explaining them in the next video. I'll be making a single video for each of them, because it is not possible to explain all of them in a single video. Okay, and coming to block cipher modes of operation, we have five modes: ECB, electronic code book, cipher block chaining, CBC, cipher feedback mode, output feedback mode, and counter mode. These are the five modes of operations we have in block cipher. I'll be explaining about each of them in detail in the next coming video. And what are the algorithms we have under block cipher are DES, AES, and Blowfish. DES stands for Data Encryption Standard, Advanced Encryption Standard, and Blowfish algorithm. About these algorithms also, I'll make an individual detailed video. So That's all for this video. I hope you guys are clear about the concept of block cipher. In block cipher, you will be dividing the plain text into number of blocks, number of single blocks, and you'll be converting each and every block into ciphertext, and then you'll be joining all the blocks in order to get the combined ciphertext, right? So this is all about this video. I hope you guys have understood clearly whatever I've explained. If you understood clearly and if you found it to be useful, hit the like button. If you have not yet subscribed to my channel, if it's the first time you're having a look at my channel, do subscribe and hit the bell icon so that you can receive the notifications whenever I post a video. And don't forget to share it with your friends so that it will be helpful for your friends as well. And feel free to comment your views and suggestions in the comment box so that I can understand what you guys are feeling about the video. If I have to make any improvements or if I have to make any changes, or if you're not able to understand or anything, feel free to comment them. If you're having any queries, if you want me to contact personally, you can contact me through the email ID, which I'll be giving you in the description box. And that's all for this video, guys. If you want me to include any other subjects or any other topics, let me know in the comment box so that I'll do it for you, and if I can. And thank you for watching the video.